In any case, thank you for listening, and I want to introduce at this point my dear friend, Arnie Nudell, the founder of Infinity and the designer of some of the world's best loudspeakers ever made. He designed the ones in the back that you hear, the Infinity IRS. He is a legend, certainly in my mind, and most of yours, and I'm going to invite Arnie up to say a few words.
Thank you for that introduction. I appreciate it. Yeah. Usually legends are dead, you know. Well, it's nice to see all of you, and it's very nice to be here. And I'd like to just tell you kind of a long story, and if you, you know, if you get tired, you can doze off. It's okay. Several years ago, I decided that maybe it was time for me to try retiring. And I did. I tried retiring. I actually made a bucket list of sorts that I thought, you know, when I did retire, that I would have all these things to do and there would be no pressure from the outside. And I can do some of these things. Since I was a kid, I was always interested in astronomy. I was actually an amateur astronomer. And because I've been so busy all my life, I really hadn't followed astronomy, which they now call cosmology. So I tried to catch up with some of that. I also decided to, you know, I have a great sound system in a wonderful listening room, and I've been designing a particular speaker for that for now about 12 years, and I thought maybe I'd have more time to really bring that to its conclusion. I mean, after 12 years, you know, it's about time. And the last thing I wanted to do was to try, with all the mathematics that I took in graduate school, maybe I should try to learn what string theory was about. Well, most of the ones I accomplished very nicely, and it was great. String theory, not so much. So I was very delighted that I had this time being retired. And it was interesting. It took one phone call, and all of that disappeared. I mean, can you imagine one phone call and your life changes? Well, that phone call was from a gentleman by the name of Jim Hannon, and he is the assistant publisher of the Absolute Sound magazine. And he called me very excitedly, and he told me in detail about this big book that the Absolute Sound was going to create. And it was called something like, it was going to be called something like The History of Audio or High Fidelity, you know, from the beginning. And the first book now, was going to be on loudspeakers. So he gave me a litany of things that he needed because they were making a very large spread on Infinity. Anyway, so Jim was describing this great book and all the stuff that I had to do with people that I knew, people from Infinity, to gather all of this information for this big spread in the book. And the Absolute Sound was dead serious about this thing. But the reason I brought up the interview is he asked me a very interesting question that I didn't expect, and really no one else had ever asked me anything like it. And that question was, look, you've been around audio for years and years. Today, what do you think might be one of the best audio pieces that there is? Now, what do you consider that to be? And I didn't have to think a second. I said, Constellation Audio Amplifier. And, you know, there was dead silence on the other end, and he kind of said, well, why? Why? And I said, well, it's really interesting. You know, Giuseppe Verdi, the great opera composer, did his greatest work in his old age. He composed the opera Otello and Falstaff. Those considered to be his greatest works. Well, similarly, I think my buddy Bascom King has done his greatest work in his old age. And again, I can say he's old because so am I. So if that interview would have taken place today, I would have said two things, and I know this is crazy, but I totally believe it. I would have said not only did Bascom King do his greatest work as an old guy, I would have said the Constellation Audio and the new PS audio amplifier. And I can tell you, I spent a long time with that, and I'll tell you, you know, in the future what I heard and why I think it is what it is. Since I didn't write a check for the Constellation Audio Amplifier, it's interesting how I got to have one and use it. Bascom and I have had a ritual every year in the month of July. And in that month, two great things happen. First thing is that where I live near Vail, Colorado, there is a music festival called Bravo Colorado. And Bravo Colorado has grown enormously. I mean, it spans 6-7 weeks. And three of the world's greatest orchestras, the New York Philharmonic, the Dallas Symphony Orchestra, and the Philadelphia Orchestra, all have residency at that festival and have had for many years. So Bascom likes to drive from Santa Barbara to Vail, Colorado. And he comes up for the Bravo Colorado Festival. The reason he drives is because his car is loaded with audio equipment that you couldn't fit a baby in the car. There is so much equipment. Now remember, he's a reviewer too, so he has stuff from reviewing, from designing, and every year he loads up his car and brings all this equipment. And why does he do that? Because I have a great listening room, and I have worked very, very hard to make what I consider a great speaker. And people have called it different names, the speaker. One person called it La Guillotine. It's strange. Another person called it the Eliminator. Well, where did all these names come from? Well, because people have brought amplifiers, preamps, players, everything under the sun that would make music before a loudspeaker and a room. And they walked out mostly with their head down because, I mean, it really did show up the defects of what they brought. I mean, not everybody, but pretty much. I mean, that's just the way this business is. I mean, you all know that. I mean, when we find something that really sounds good, it's not just picking it out of a catalog. I mean, you do a lot of research, you do listening, and of course, hopefully you find something that really satisfies you, that sounds like music. About 3.5 years ago, Bascom with his loaded car came up, got to the driveway, I gave him a big hug, and of course his car was loaded down with stuff which we had unloaded. And we opened the trunk, and in the trunk was something that looked like a dinosaur bones. But I finally looked at it closely, and it was a skeleton type amplifier, and it was about this wide, about this high. I'm asking, what is that? He says, that is my handmade Constellation audio amplifier, and you're going to hear what it sounds like. Now, I read reviews, and people were, you know, really excited about the sound of this. And frankly, I had never heard, and Paul said it, I had never heard a transistor amp or a solid state amp that sounded anywhere near as musical as my tube amps. I heard many solid state amplifiers, and none of them came close to the great tube amps that I had. And I had some modified tube amps. They were each mono section had 8 KT-88s in it. It was wonderful. Every 8 months I had to spend about $1,500 just to retube it. But I didn't care because it did make music. It really made music. And I said to a lot of people, I'm now eating my words, but I will be, that I would never sell those amplifiers, that I would always keep them because everything else that I heard put up against them, in my mind, failed. They didn't produce music. And when I say produce music, I mean, if you're not getting the emotional content of the composer and the players, then it's not really music, it's just sound. But if you do get the emotional content, then that is what I consider music. Just like when you're at a concert, the emotion comes right at you and you feel it. Now, some audio components do better than others for sometimes unknown reasons and sometimes known reasons why this is the case. So my amplifiers, those tube amplifiers, were extraordinary at producing that part of the music. So Bascom trots in here with this Constellation audio amplifier, and he was looking very trepidatious when we hooked it up because we had to balance it a bit because the gains were a bit different from my amplifier. And, you know, Bascom sometimes is a glass half full guy. And he's a perfect friend because I'm a half full guy. He's a half empty guy, sorry. We hooked it up and played it. And frankly, I was shocked. I mean, I was really shocked. Now, I can make all kinds of waving my arms. Well, this is better because there's no transistors in this amplifier. Yes, it's solid state, but it's all MOSFET. So I said, well, MOSFETs are much better behaved than transistors, and you know, I could wave my arms forever. But the fact was that for the first time, I heard a solid state amp that produced the emotion of music, beautiful mid-range, gorgeous high end. I mean, it was really something that was astounding to me. And I said to Bascom, I said, whoa, I mean, this is really something. And, you know, he was very happy, and like, so was I. And I was thinking to myself, boy, wouldn't it be nice if I had one of those things? I could play a lot of music on them. I wouldn't have to replace the tubes every 8 months. So a year later, he comes driving up in the driveway, and we hug each other and open the trunk, and there's an amplifier that looked just like the one he brought last year, but it looked a little different to me. And it was. He made an amplifier, handmade an amplifier for me, just like the one that he brought up the year before. And boy, I'll tell you, that was the nicest thing that anybody could do for me because I enjoyed that amp so much. It was incredible. And, you know, a lot of the reviews of that amp, you know, we all shrug our shoulders sometimes at these reviewers that exaggerate a lot.
Showbiz. Showbiz, you know.
I know. But in this case, a lot of the words of the reviewers are really true. I mean, this amp did produce music. And, you know, as I said, I was astonished. So Bascom made one for me, and I was able to use it. Let's just take it back a couple years to when I was, in quote, retired, which didn't last long. I get calls from this guy. He says, Arnie, PS Audio is now making an amplifier, and, you know, could I bring it up and listen to it, you know, with your system and your speakers and room? Sure. Now, I'm not going to go into any detail what he brought up, but he did bring up an amplifier, okay? And
not to interrupt your story, but yeah. I brought up an amplifier, and you know the guillotine that he's talking about? Every single time I came up there, he said, nice try, young man.
Yeah. Actually, my words were not that. They were much harsher than that. Anyway, the first one, well, not very good. The second one, better. Not very good. So Paul says, I got to try once more. And I said, well, wait a minute. Let's sit down. So we went to the table and we had some lunch together. And I said, wait a minute. I don't think this is going anywhere, Paul. And you really told me that you want an amp to be really great because, like his great DAC, for example, PS Audio is striving for something much better. I mean, the price has to be right. But it much better than they had done in the past. And they were looking much, much higher in terms of performance. And he certainly got it with the DAC. I think if you heard it, you know. So I suggested to him, I said, look, why don't we forget about this and PS Audio designing it? Since Bascom King designed the Constellation audio amplifier, and it's so damn good, why don't you get Bascom, commission him to design an amplifier, not to copy another amplifier, but something like that that would sound like that. So he bought it, of course. But before I had him completely hooked, I had to spring the killer for him. And I said, Paul, how about, would you, why don't you?
No. You said.
Yeah, all right.
Paul,
yeah.
You're not going to like this one bit.
Yeah.
That's what you said.
Yes, I did. But what you really have to do is put vacuum tubes at the front end of this amplifier. And he looked at me and I figured, boy, now the shit's going to fly. Yeah. But that didn't happen. He really thought about it. And I thought, is this the new Paul McGowan? And he thought about it and he said, you know, Arnie, I really consider that. That sounds really interesting. And then he asked me why I thought that, and we had this long conversation. The bottom line is that's exactly what he did. And I think that was a phenomenal decision. And the amplifier that Bascom King turned out with that tube front end and MOSFETs all the way through it. I mean, very different design than Constellation Audio, but still MOSFETs all the way through it. That amplifier turned out even better than I imagined. And I imagined that was going to be a killer amplifier. But I've had it at my home now for about 6 weeks. The reason is because Paul asked me to send it back, and I told him the packing it wouldn't make it, and you know. So finally, it was in the back of my car, and I brought it today. But I did have a good 6 weeks with it, and I'll tell you. Anybody want to buy a couple of really good tube amplifiers? I mean, I'll make you a great price. And I'm the guy that said I'd never sell those things. But this amplifier is so far better than those tube amplifiers in every way across the board that it is really incredible. And I'm just so happy that I'm here to tell you about, you know, how good this is. I think a lot of people are going to be surprised that you don't have to pay hundreds of thousands of dollars for an amplifier that has this kind of performance. And I firmly believe that. Do you have any questions for me? Well, you're good. Thanks, guys.
Well, hold on, Arnold. Hang on. So Bascom, come on up here. I want to.
Yes.
So in 1979, they introduced the world to the first hybrid amplifier that has, in my opinion, changed forever what we listen to today, certainly what PS Audio is producing. So in honor of that, we went out and bought two bottles of 1979.
Oh my God.
Whoa. Wine. And because Arnie is the wine aficionado, you get to choose. Do you want the French or the California? Should we fight it out later?
Yeah, we'll fight it out later. It's fine.
All right, so right now I'll give Bascom's from California. Yeah, and you're going to drink it together?
He and I are going to drink both of them anyway.
Well, here you are, sir.
All right, well, thank you very much.
Yeah.
Woohoo, this could be really good.
Thank you. Man, what a gift. Thank you.